Hey, what's up guys? I'm finally back from that couple week long break. I had just had crap to deal with, like school and stuff, but I got all kinds of stuff to go. So I'm not going to talk it all about right now. I'll just talk about it as I do them. So yeah, let's get started. You're changing ways. I met a cheerleader, was a real young breed. All the times like a reminisce. All the best things of loving with a sister and a cousin. Only started with a little kiss like this. No. Alright, we're gonna start off with this little coil. I'm pretty sure this is an inductor coil. I pulled this off of that mouse circuit board where we've blown already. So, try to get away from that. Excuse me. Anyway. Oh, that didn't just smoke out like it normally would as a coil. It actually just popped and did random stuff. And keeps trying to burn my hand. Come here. Well, yeah. I barely see any carnage. That's all it did. Keeps trying to burn me. Alright, here we have this board. It's from a multimeter. My multimeter was being a piece of crap. Remember that video called I have an ohm detector and I use it? It's one of my really, really old videos. It's one of my first videos of the second attempt of this channel. So it's still there if you want to watch it. But yeah. Well, the ohm detector is actually just a multimeter. It was a very cheap multimeter. It didn't work properly after a couple months of having it. Even after getting new batteries for it, it wouldn't work properly, so. Plus, I barely used it, so I didn't really need it anymore. So I decided to donate this to the show. It has a couple components we can pull off of there, but yeah. That's it. I'm getting output. Yeah, I tried to blow up a multimeter motherboard before. It didn't go. So I guess it's because there's no high voltage. They can hold up high voltage up to about 600 volts. And that's probably why it didn't go. It's stupid though. Oh, come on, don't be a piece of crap. Damn, my screwdriver's over there. Come on. The heck is that? Well, that's a fuse. I'm not asking what that is. I'm just asking what I'm hearing. It sounds like I hear something in the house. Let's see what the speaker will do. There's like a very tiny little speaker on this board. Plus, this might actually give voltage to the board so the board can blow as well. I hope that's actually contacting on the contacts of the speaker, because the contacts on that speaker is small and stupid. It's actually kind of hard to do that. Here we go. Ooh! I don't know how it shot smoke over here, but it actually shot smoke past the tablet. That's weird. But at least something finally went on this board. Yeah, just the speaker went. I guess nothing else went. I saw that burn mark is from just the speaker. Here we have this other capacitor. I guess is what it is. It's this screen thing. I'm gonna pull it off. We'll hook it up. See what it'll do. If we can hook it up, it looks like it'll give us quite the difficulty. Quite soldering though. Now we're done with that board. We got the fuse and stuff already. And guess what? Blow the fuse in a moment. I don't know. Should we try to get that capacitor? Seems like if I hook it, the way I hook it up will short it up. So I'm just questioning that decision. Oh well, let's try hooking it up anyway, unless it keeps being a piece of crap. I mean, we can always use the short terminal wires. I apologize for not pausing for a while there. It was kind of stupid, but I did even try the short terminal wires. The capacitor is just being an idiot. Either that or just the short terminal wires being... Ow, what the heck? Being broken. I don't know how that thing shocked me, but it's off. I know it's off, so... I don't know what the heck's going on with this, these clips. Or that power wire, I should say. It's all stupid, but at least we got this fuse now. This is the fuse from that multimeter board, so let's hope it goes good. It is. Has nothing. It has, the filaments are still good. So let's just absolutely annihilate this thing. That's it. Wow. Lame. It did some at least, but it didn't do very good at all. Wow. Really? Ugh. What the heck, you piece of crap? Yeah. Now I found this guy. This is a light bulb from a string of Christmas lights. I'm not sure. I found these individual in a drawer for some reason, and found quite a few of them. So I don't know what string of lights they're from, but I just took one. But oh well. So for old time's sakes, let's do this one. Remember, I'm not the Grinch. I do love Christmas. That's my favorite holiday of the year. But I'm still just getting rid of this, because why not? That was it, really? I would have done more. These even kind of pop like capacitors. Not exactly like them, but just somewhat like them. This thing did explode, though. It's kind of weird. The heck, clip and hook like that. I'm in the menu, if you know what I'm saying. Ugh. Ooh. 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 New pieces of glass. Alright, now we're gone to speakers. Well, for right now, anyway. We got this whoa. Hammer there. We got this speaker. This is from a surround sound system. I only have the one though because it was ruined and it was crappy. So this is, I don't know what the exists. I don't know what sound system this is from. There's only three tags on the back. I believe three tags. One of them, oh yeah, there was three tags. One of them was the price tag because it was at a thrift store. The other one said surround center or surround speaker left. And then it had the QC tested sticker. So it didn't have any labeling or anything on it. I did find this though on the magnetic shield. It says Flyball. That's weird. But it's FQ34 something 2. 8 ohms at 4 ohms at 8 watts. I doubt it's even 8 watts. I was playing around with this speaker on the dual amp. I didn't get the video though, but it didn't really smoke or anything at all. It did ruin the voice coil though, so it's locked up. Not completely locked, but still. It still works though, it's just very crappy and it has a little bit of life left in it. So this may not be as So this may actually be even worse than this thing would be if... So this thing may do a worse job of blowouts than it would do if it was fine. If it was still good. Or if it was still in better condition, the voice coil. So, I apologize for blowing it too early. But it still has a bit of life left in it. We're gonna finish it off. Sorry for the long intermission between blowouts. but at least it's all hooked up now. Let's just go ahead and get this guy done for. Whoa! Wonder what it would actually do if it was fine. Welcome on, amazing ramp! See it? Ooh! The magnet came off. That's one pathetic magnet. It did also have an extra magnet to it, just to help add even more magnetic shield to it. But those didn't work out very good. Most of the work is actually done by this guy. And the voice coil is just right there. It's very small, so it's definitely not 8 watts. It's only like 3. Like maybe 5 at the most. I might as well get it out of the thing. Garbage. More garbage. Shouldn't have to say that though. Ow. I know y'all can see this from the other side of the basket. I'm still taking it off anyway, just to give you a better look. But there you go. That's the little coil. That's maybe 5 watts at the absolute most, but I doubt it's 8. I guess I'll deal with that later. Iowa, a very crappy piece of crap. Speaker system, I only got the one though. Music power, that's peak power, not music power, because you're going to be sending movie power to this thing. 40 watts, yeah, right. Like that little coil will even hold up to that. 16 ohms, normally the standard is either 4 or 6 or 8. Made in China, no crap. Just a bunch of crap. Model number of the system is SX-R210. And that's the little piece of crap. Just a port. And a stupid thing. Yeah, you see how little that coil is? This is my index finger. It literally just fits inside. So this thing is just nothing. I'm actually kind of surprised it has a metal voice coil skeleton. But it is still a piece of crap. It sounds horrible. Because, well, it's Iowa. Like, a few of their products is actually, like, average quality. And the rest of their crap is like this. Crappy. Alright, let's see what this one will do. Move it back. Without, hopefully, it won't short out. It shortened short out. See it good?
All right, let's see what Iowa will do. Enough of this pause and talking. Whoa! Oh my god! That was quite a lot for what I expected from this thing.
Got the tablet. I'm just stomping the crap out of this thing. I screw that. Come on. Oh. Bunch of crap.
Speaker. The other side of that. Piece of crap.
I hope I can still get that coil out. That's a big spider though. It's a big spider.
Let's
It's kind of weird, it has such a big spider, it's not much I'm in for excursion. Does that look 40 watts to you? Yeah, freaking right. Oh, look at that. They even used cheap screws. I was able to break that screw. Wow. I was a freaking joke. That's all they are. If you ever find these, don't get them unless you're like me. You just want to destroy them. Yeah, screw that. Just go savage. Screw you, Lala. Screw you. Stay there. The monster's returning. All these crap. Screw you, Iowa. 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 I'm saying Iowa, the speaker brand, not the state. Screw the stupid speaker brand. Screw these stupid speakers because they're that crappy. And screw that. Quit falling. Oh, capacitors, I forgot about them. You've seen the pile. I've only got 3 more capacitors left. The reason that is because this is a couple weeks from the time that this video was released. So this video right now, like this part of the video, is still a couple weeks behind. So I will get more speakers on September the 5th, most likely anyway. Should get myself some home audio, some more crappy home audio speakers. Just a bunch of, just a couple of, or a few speakers from thrift stores. And I might even get some car speakers by then too. If I'm lucky, I might get some Kicker 6x9s. But I probably not though. Yeah, so that probably won't happen for a while. I'm gonna do an update video as well. So yeah. I'm also hopefully getting some speakers from Grandma's truck. I'll explain more later, but I don't even know if I'm gonna get them. So without further ado, let's get these capacitors done. Alright, we got 3 capacitors. I got this little guy, and then we got 2 big guys. The one of them I'm gonna do regularly, the other one I'm gonna do reverse polarity. And this little guy, I'm using reverse polarity. So let's see this pops for old time's sake. They're very loud too. They're literally mini gunshots. Well, it could just be that smells kinda nice. It's like a mixture of popcorn and pizza. That's weird. They might be being amplified like that because they're in a box. That might be why. Oh well. Like I said, this one will be correct polarity. The other one is the same size, but it'll be hooked up a different polarity. But look what I found. This is from that last capacitor. Just thought I'd show y'all that in case y'all wanted to see it. But yeah, get out of there. Alright, let's see what these big things do. Oh, by the way, I forgot to tell you, that capacitor, that last capacitor we did, I just found in that drawer with the Christmas light, which is kind of weird. I believe that was mine and Shane took, or my stepdad took it. But yeah. And then this capacitor and the other capacitor are pretty much the same thing. They were actually the little crossover for that Iowa speaker. So, yeah. So I have both capacitors off. I had to rewire it. The Iowa speaker. Anyway, let's see what this one will do. Jeez. Loud as usual. Hey, it didn't actually really pop. Well, I mean, it did pop, but it didn't pop itself off. It just did the cap. I don't know why, but this one smells weird. It doesn't smell like its usual smell. It smells like nicotine, like someone smoking. That's weird. I'm starting to wonder if there's even nicotine in these anyway. I doubt it, but I feel weird. Whoa, that thing is off. Why does it feel weird? So how does this feel? Oh, this one's welded, I think. Yeah, I mean, I just fixed it, but still, I think, yeah, that capacitor messed up my clips, I believe. They're not completely messed up, but still. There's what happened. Just literally blew its top off. Alright, here's this one. This one's pretty much the same thing. Just, it's very identical. But this one's hooked up in the wrong way. If it does pop off, it'll hit the tablet, I'm pretty sure. Oh yeah, I gotta plug it in. Yeah, this, yeah, that thing, that, those wires still gave off electricity even when the power bar is off, so I had to unplug it. Anyway, that was it. Even the other one was better, even though it was hooked up right. It smells like fireworks now. And a slight bit of popcorn, but it's barely noticeable. That's weird. Wiring connections are still fine. Yeah, still got an output on the power bar. So that's it for the capacitor. That's it for right now. I will get more on September the 5th, hopefully. Hopefully as much as I want. But yeah. Until then. Hey, what's up, you guys? Luxurious Home Service here. Sorry about that. But it's finally a couple weeks later on Sunday, the September 6th. Got good news and bad news. I guess I'll start with the bad news. The ESW8 is pretty well dead. The amp is, I don't know what happened to it. I guess I did put speaker level input into the RCA, which is supposed to have line level input and not speaker line. So I ended up screwing up the amplifier. I even tried the actual speaker line input, speaker level, and it didn't work either. So the actual amp is messed up, not the input thing, not the input circuits and whatever. So now I have to have a wire coming straight from the subwoofer output of this receiver all the way to the sub through the port, because through the amp and stuff won't work. So I stick a wire through the port to the actual sub itself. So this is powering the sub, not the plate amp, which is not very good. I don't have a very good gain, and I don't have as much quality in the bass, but it's gonna be my temporary solution. It's good enough for a temporary solution until I can either fix it or get a new sub. But on the bright side, I went to a couple of thrift stores last night, mainly Waterfront as usual. That's my main thrift store is Waterfront. I don't know why I forgot it there for a second. This is one of the speaker enclosures I got. The speakers are out of it because it had a crossover. I am not going to save the crossover, so I'm just going to get rid of it too. But here's the enclosure. This is going to be for like a little destruction video. This destruction video will be separate. Plus the blowout video may be too long anyway, so it might be two or three videos coming out today. I'm not sure yet. But yeah, we got some lights, a flashlight. We got like four of those finger lights in here. And that light bulb that says on the box. And then we got flashlight, like I said, we got a Jensen, iPod dock, gateway, computer speakers, and of course this Yamaha enclosure. But that's all just for a destruction, and there's the cover. Got this Iowa Center channel. Music, I wonder why they keep saying music power. That's ridiculous, but my second Iowa speaker blown. Cool. And this is, of course, better than the last one, but still a piece of crap. So I guess it's probably 16 ohms onto one 8 ohm load. Because of how I have it wired up, it's in series. Some kind of series, anyway. The center channel is kind of heavy for what it is. I wonder why it's so heavy. Yeah, I'll let y'all look at that while we're outside. Got the other gateway speaker. The one gateway speaker, the other one anyway, the terminals broke when I attempted to do it free air, or when I attempted to have it like free air for today. And the terminal broke, so I had to convert it into a voice coil instead, which is stupid. So I kept this one as it is in its enclosure. We'll take the cover off when we get out. This is the woofer from that Yamaha. The dust cap was actually messed up. It was slightly rotting, and I'm getting black crap all over my fingers. And it's still on my finger. But yeah, it's actually not that bad, but I don't have use for it. Cloths around, paper cone. It feels like poly, though. Not bad of the magnet size. My hand compared to it, it's pretty nice. The one on the energy is slightly bigger. Cool. The tweeters is in a little bag. And you got this RCA speaker. It looks like a phone dock for an old landline phone. And this is one I've been wanting to get for this blowout day for a while now. I did look these up and it says this is kind of rare. So it'd be kind of a shame to blow it up if that's the case. This gateway speaker, I did look it up. It's the G2100. It's a 2.1 system. I don't have the sub, I just had the two satellites. But yeah, so Diamond Audio probably makes these. I don't know. Who cares? And then we got then we got the crossover from that Yamaha speaker, the tweeter from that Yamaha speaker, some Jensen speaker drivers, 4-inch drivers. One of them's a voice coil along with that gateway. And we have a couple loose components, a couple capacitors, an inductor, and probably a fuse, some kind of fuse. And we have a Logitech mouse circuit board. So I have quite the blowout today. At least I hope. My best high hopes is from this guy. Y'all remember that RCA sub I blew a while back? Or even that Boston Acoustics? I guess you can say we're resembling that with this Yamaha today. First Yamaha, first RCA. Blowing my first Yamaha, my first RCA, my second Iowa, my first Gateway, my first Jensen. So these are all like new blowouts for me mostly. The only thing that's not new is the electrolytic capacitors, the inductor, and the that mouse circuit board, because it's barely anything different. I'm trying to set everything back because I do have to transfer all this outside. But yeah, I guess I showed you all of it and didn't have to talk about it outside. But yeah, this will be a separate video, but yeah. Alright, let's get outside and do this. Hey, I just checked my gallery, and it's like, if I add the rest of that video to the video I already did in a video I've done a couple weeks ago, it'd be a little too long, so I'm definitely gonna have to do this blowout video in a two-part kind of thing. It'll be uploaded separately, so. Yeah, I'm gonna still be uploading
just two videos today.
Unless y'all want like a really long special. But no. That's a little too boring, so. Yeah. See y'all later in the next video.